Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be sharing 11 self-care tips for reducing stress and finding peace. And a huge thank you to Parissa Wax for sponsoring this video. Let's start by setting the mood. I like to unwind by putting on a silk robe and lighting a scented candle. Whenever I think of self-care, I think of skincare. So I'm going to steam the face for about a minute. And here's a tip, add a drop of eucalyptus oil to the steamer to relax your mind. Next up, I'm going to exfoliate the skin. Here's a tip, use a liquid exfoliant to really help remove dead skin cells and impurities. I just apply a little bit of this on cotton pads and then rub all over the face and neck. Exfoliating once a week can really help renew your skin. Freshly waxed brows are one of my favorite things for self-care. Here, I'll be using the Parissa Brow Wax Strips. I'm going to trim the brow hair just a little bit and cut a few of these mini wax strips. They're mess-free and easy to use. You just warm the wax strips between your hands and they are 100% biodegradable and fragrance-free. You just place it on the unwanted hairs and then hold the skin taut and pull in the opposite direction. There you go. I go over the areas a few times and it works so well. I love how it's so easy to use. They're the perfect size and it just gets rid of those unwanted brow hairs in less than a few seconds. After I've waxed, I will apply the Ultra Soothe oil all over the brows just to give it that nice clean look and to get rid of any wax. Both brows are done, they look super clean, and I'm very happy with it. One thing I've been obsessed with is the Parissa Mini Pearl Wax Warmer. Instead of using a microwave, this tool will melt the wax quickly and ensure a smooth application each time. One of my other favorites is the Parissa Organic Sugar Wax. It's vegan and it's perfect to use on face, body, and the bikini. Its non-toxic formula has comforting chamomile and easily washes off with water. You can also use the promo code CHIUTIPS25 to get 25% off your entire order. Next up, I'm going to dermaplane the face. Here's a tip, go along the growth of hair and use soft, light strokes when removing any unwanted hair. Once you're done, just wipe off with a wet cloth. So how do I reduce stress and find peace? Writing in my gratitude journal. I always feel mentally lighter when I write down what I'm grateful for. And here's a tip, try making a habit of writing in a journal every day for a few minutes. Next up, meditation. I love using the Headspace app for my daily meditation practice. Meditation not only helps me manage anxiety and stress, it also helps me fall asleep better at nighttime. Here's a tip that really works for me. I would recommend using noise cancellation headphones so that you aren't distracted. Moving right along, bring feng shui into your home. This is an ancient practice of space alignment in your home. I always like starting with my bed. I feel like once I do this in the morning, everything seems to fall into place. Here's a tip, even moving a few objects to a new spot can leave a space feeling brighter and with more energy. I also love calming scents in my home. The Season Aero SM Portable and Water Diffuser is my go-to for this. A little bit of feng shui can really bring a different kind of energy into your home too. And of course, clear the clutter. For me, it's the kids' play area. Henry goes to a Montessori school, so we want to make sure we also implement some of that stuff at home. We use child height Montessori furniture to keep toys at their height. The optimum number of activities in the playroom is around 8 to 10, and sometimes I have more and sometimes I have less, but creating a toy rotation about once a week can really help my little one engaged with all the activities. To me, less is more and I want to keep things simple. My goal is to allow them to focus on few things and master them instead of jumping around from toy to toy and activity to activity. So how do I find peace? This is when self-reflection comes in handy. Here's a tip, ask yourself questions like, how am I feeling today? What can I improve on? And what have I learned this year? Doing this regularly can reduce stress level, spark creativity, and allow for better decision making. And lastly, spending time with my kids. Here's a tip, just spend time engaging in any activity you like. For me, it's playing the piano. It's always something that has helped me de-stress. I also love playing for my kids and it creates a very special bonding moment for us. So those are some of my self-care tips to help with reducing anxiety and find peace. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that subscribe button and that notification bell so you don't miss out on anything new. Thanks for watching and see you guys in the next one. Bye for now.